Let this meeting come to order at 6 o'clock. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming. Please forgive me, I had surgery in my mouth, so I know I stuttered before, but I'm going to stutter a lot more probably today. But anyhow, please forgive me for that. If you don't understand me, please stop me and I'll try to explain. At this time, we're going to open meeting at 6 o'clock. Roll call. Mr. Alvarez.
Here.
Ms. Gomez.
Here.
Mr. Macarino.
Here.
Ms. Lopez.
Here.
Myself, I am here. But before I get started, do we need interpretation? I believe everybody speaks English and Spanish here, so I guess we should be okay, right? Anyhow, we go to flag salute. Board members, if we can please stand.
Mr. Davis, can you lead us, please?
Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
There's a lot of room up here still. We go ahead and go to 4.0, 4.1, adoption of the agenda as requested.
Move.
We have a motion on the floor and a second. Motion by Ms. Lopez, second by Mr. Alvarez. Is that correct?
Yes.
That being said, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, that carries 5-0. We go to 8.0, public comments. Member of the public may address the board on any agenda item described in the notice before and during consideration of that item. The board is not able to discuss or take action on any item not appearing on this agenda. A 3-minute time limit will be imposed in public input for individual issues. Do we have anything, sir?
There are nobody. Keep brought a card.
Okay, thank you. Excuse me, folks, but I think I have to turn my phone on. Testing. Can you still hear me? Thank you. We move on to 13.1, personnel. Consideration of approval resolution 22-03-06-24, determining the tiebreaker criteria for purpose of certificated reduction for 2024-2025 school year. Do we have a motion?
No.
Do we have a motion on the floor? We have a motion on the floor by Ms. Lopez, second by Mr. Oliver. Is that correct?
Yes.
That being said, board members, do you have any questions? If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? That carries 5-0. Again, forgive me. I'll probably be going real slow on this, okay? Thank you. 13.2, consider the approval of resolution 23.3-06-24, elimination of certificated employee services for the 2024-2025 school years due to reduction of particular kinds of services. Do we have a motion? Do I have a motion?
For discussion only.
I have a motion for discussion.
Second for discussion.
I have a motion for discussion by Ms. Lopez, second by Mr. Alvarez. Is that correct? Let's open discussion. Ms. Lopez, go ahead.
These positions listed, what are they coming out of? Are they coming out of general fund? Are they COVID money? Are they ESSERs?
They are all, the certificated ones are coming out of ESSERs and LCAP. ESSERs, because ESSERs money is ending, obviously. Excuse me?
ESSERs ends on what day?
On June 30th.
This year?
Yes.
Okay.
And the LCAP is due to a reduction in unduplicated counts, so there'll be a reduction in LCAP funding moving forward after this year. So for those two reasons, those are the two funding sources which these positions came from on the certificated side. it was understood that ESSER money was a certain finite money for 3 years. And it was common knowledge and should be understood that it was. I was in, it ends at the end of this year. So it's money that is ending. It's very finite. And it's across the state. So that's something that districts right now are facing across the state. So the ending of the ESSER money.
One additional question. Is this going to create a gap in anything, any services?
It will not create a gap. We just have to go back to the drawing board and create a different format to provide intervention for students than the current model.
My question.
Go ahead, Mr. Alvarez.
My question is, in refilling these positions, funding-wise, where do you expect that funding is going to come from?
Hold on a second. Sorry about that.
Do you have any idea where that funding is going to come from to pay for these positions that we need to keep or redesign?
The redesign will probably still come out of LCAP, but at a lower price. That's something that's yet to be determined. So we're still looking and seeking out different grants. So, but we can't count on the grants right now. We have to go with base what we have right now as far as information.
And the loss of LCAP funding is due to ADA? Or?
It's due to a drop in unduplicated count. So we dropped an unduplicated count, and we also have declining enrollment, which is something that Mr. Kapp spoke to at the last meeting.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you.
Ms. Gomez?
Basically, I think Mr. Alvarez and Ms. Lopez kind of answered the question I was going to ask as well. My only thing is that I know we came out with this, that we all, and you said something in regard, we do have another plan that we're going to go by or we're going to look into? Was that my understanding?
For the sake of the cuts, we don't have another plan. This is the easiest plan in the sense that these three elements are already taking place regardless. ESSER money is ending, that's a fact. LCAP funding is being reduced, that's a fact. And then the third factor that has to do in a separate, I'll speak to when we get to that resolution. But for now, for the sake of the certificated, these are the two factors. And management is also impacted. So management at 11%. Certificated at 6% due to the ESSER money ending.
Thank you. Mr. Alvarez, any other questions?
No.
Ms. Gomez?
No.
Mr. Macarino?
I actually do have a
go ahead,
question.
Sir.
Now, the affected employees, I understand that we have a fiduciary responsibility as a board.
Mm-hmm.
I do understand that. Now, the affected employees, if they're having to go and do this, will they be have, if ever those jobs open up, will they have
yes,
a priority?
Yes, they have the first right to rehire.
Okay. And how long is that kept for? Let's say if there's no funding, they lose their jobs, and then is there like a time period?
For the most part, it's for one academic year. That is kept open as needed. There's no set fine line, but especially there's a big change when it comes to August. We still have to factor in any attrition or any loss due to retirement or resignations, which would then open up additional opportunities for those individuals who are impacted to come back.
And if we were not to do this, is there an impact in any way to...
If we were not to make these cuts, then what would happen is the general fund will have to absorb these positions, which runs the risk of further us 3 years out being qualified by the county, our budget, because we would be under the 3% threshold.
And as I understand it, this is something that is statewide. ESSER money is across the state.
Across the country, because the ESSER money is federal.
Across the country. Okay.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Ms. Lopez?
No, I got my answer.
Okay, thank you. We do have a motion on the floor by Ms. Lopez, second by Mr. Alvarez. Is that correct? Do you stand by that?
Yes.
Okay. At this time, we go for a vote. I'm going to come for a vote. Mr. Alvarez?
Yes.
Ms. Gomez?
No.
Mr. Macarino?
Yes, with a comment.
Ms. Lopez?
Yes.
And Mr. Vasquez, I vote no. So that's 5-0. Excuse me, 5-3-2. Mr. Do you have a comment, Mr. Macarino?
Sorry about that. It goes against my grain to actually approve this. However, I know that when I came upon this board, I realized that there's going to be a lot of different type of responsibilities that I would have to take into consideration. And it seems in the discussions that we've had before in terms of with the board, ESSER's monies, that we knew that was going to run out. And we had hoped, perhaps, to have something ready, or hopefully something will come in to not only save these jobs or even to bring back the employee. I think it's very important because I do know the service to students. I do know how important your jobs are in keeping this district going. But we're kind of in a crunch because if we do vote or we do not eliminate, that may create other kinds of job losses or other kinds of losses in terms of programs. And I'm assured by the superintendent that we are going to digitally look for funding for these jobs. It's not saying bye-bye now, but hopefully within the next, before June 30th is here, we'll find something. And if not, then you have priority, but I just want to say it goes against my grain to vote yes on this, so.
Say no.
Yeah. I have a petition. I have a responsibility as a board member. And I just wanted to share that with you.
Thank you, Mr. Macarino.
I have a comment also.
Go ahead, sir.
You know, I've been in business on my own for my whole life, entirely on my own, independent. And it's not to say that I've been financially responsible for myself, my crews, my companies, and sometimes we have to prepare for the future. And that's not to say that we can't have the superintendent find funds before June 30th, right? That's the whole objective. And everybody's out there right now looking for grants and funding right now, and they're trying to find ways of recouping this lost ESSER funds, right? So that should be our goal. That's what we should be trying to accomplish now before June 30th. So for me, it's a business decision. And believe you me, I love my kids. I've been a part of the community, coaching teams and sponsoring for more than 30 years. So it's a hard decision, but it's a business decision for me. And I look for the best that we have for our children. And I got grandbabies here in this community. And I'm dealing with issues just like every other parent in here, doing the best that we can to assist with our children in the classrooms and things of that nature. So, you know, I'm kind of torn between two spots, but I'm supposed to be financially, fiscally responsible, and that's why I'm here on the board, to take care of the kids for the future. And this is a hurdle we've come to. It's a blockade. We must get past. We must move forward. and it's going to require everyone in this district office to make this happen and get this funding here before June 30th. And that is the test of a good district office. All right? That's the test. So, you know, a lot of people knew when they were hired, the ESSER funds came in, they knew it was going to end, right? So it's not a surprise. Let's just prepare for it, and let's try to move forward the best we can. So I'm counting on the district office to find this funding before the end of the year. Thank you.
Thank you. If not any other questions, we did have a motion, and it did pass 3-2. We move on 13.3. Consider approval resolution 24-3-6-24, reduction and elimination classified employee services for the 2024-2025 school years due to lack of work and lack of funds. Do I have a motion? I ask again, do I have a motion?
Mine is solely for discussion.
A motion for discussion. Do I have a second?
Second for discussion.
We have a motion for discussion, Ms. Lopez, second by Mr. Macarino. Is that correct?
Yes.
Is open for discussion. Go ahead, Ms. Lopez.
Of all these positions, does that leave any at any site? Do we have any that will remain?
We do have instructional services, as far as instructional aides, that are servicing special education because of very specific legal pieces with regards to the IEP. But yes, we're in the same situation as we are in the other resolution. We have to notify the individuals and by March 15th, but we're continuing to look for additional funding.
Were all those specially funded under limited?
They were all ESSER funded. All of the instructional aides were ESSER funded.
And all were noticed of this?
Well, none have been noticed.
No, noticed when they were hired that this was.
It was understood, yes.
And when we did this hiring, I know that I specifically mentioned that we just do not like to lay off people or let go of people. But we were told that they would definitely be aware that this was not, it was just temporary funding. So my, again.
Yes, not only that, the bargaining units were aware. And in our discussions, for quite a while now. And they're all ESSER-funded positions.
Do we have a plan to make up for the loss? Because we can't say it's due to lack of work. For sure
it's not due to lack of work. There's two kinds of releases. There's one kind of release that is based on budget, which is that's what this is. And then there's the other one that's based on performance or probationary status that are considered non-reelects. That's a separate matter. Right now, it's a matter based on budget. So it's based on the sunsetting of ESSER funds that the alternative would be to absorb them into the general fund, and then we would have to be laying off teachers, additional teachers, to offset one or the other. Because it would put the district in... Mr. Cap, what would it be if we did none of the cuts? We would end up with a 3-year out of 1 point something, you had said originally?
Yes, if we did none of the cuts, most likely the 3-year out would be less than 3%, which means that...
I can't hear. Can you stand up, please?
Yes. So if the board did none of the cuts, the 3-year out would most likely be less than 3% based on these projections, the ones that I presented at second hearing. What that would mean would be the second or third year out is less than 3%, our budget is qualified. Mm-hmm. At that point, the county steps in to start helping the district manage the costs and bring the expenditures down.
And then the county would do the layoffs. So, but the decision is up to the board. my responsibility is to keep our district fiscally solvent in order to be able to meet the needs as we continue to find additional funding. And the reason why we're doing this is because by law, we have to properly notify individuals who are impacted by March 15th. That's the law of California. So we have to notify. A notification of potential layoff is not a total guarantee. While we are still looking, the final word comes out at the end of the fiscal year.
Yeah, exactly.
Any other questions, ma'am?
Just a comment.
Let me go to Mr. Macarino. Okay. You have any questions, sir?
How soon, let's say we have no funding, how soon will the employee know that come June 30th, there's no funding? How much time will they have?
So March 15th.
Well, the notice is now.
Well, I know now.
But in the wording of the notification is that they will find out, you know, what will happen is if we get additional funding, then we post the position and we notify the individuals before we post because they have the first right to return.
Exactly.
Okay. Thank you.
Ms. Gomez?
No.
Mr. Alvarez?
Yeah, again, everyone must be notified. We could pull money from general fund. We could, but you must be notified. We have to. I'd rather be prepared than not prepared. All right? I'd rather know where we're going than be surprised later that you're there. So this is the policy procedure. And again, there's possible money in general funding to do this, but I think we can get a hold of a couple of grants to take care of this thing, but we must notify everyone. So, anyway.
Any other questions, sir? Ms. Gomez? Mr. Macarino? Ms. Lopez?
No.
Only one question to you, Mr. Dr. Chavez. How did we come up with the reductions? How did you guys calculate how many hours you were going to be cutting in all these positions? Pardon?
There's a plan.
What's the plan?
ESSER plan.
It's all reflected on the plan, the ESSER plan.
So on the ESSER plan, it's reduction. Yeah. So this amount of money came out. Some of these people losing not only their hourly, but they're also losing the benefits.
Here's the plan. Well, it's just for the plan for the funding for the position. But in the funding also obviously covers the benefits. So it is... Yeah, it's the hours and the benefits.
And what is the savings on that if we do those cuts?
Let me tell you right now.
Excuse me, ma'am. I'll get to your question in a little bit.
The savings on the ESSER is $923,911. Which is not a savings, that's the money we're losing from ESSERs.
Even with the reductions of what we're doing on the hourlies?
No. That is, you had asked how much we were gonna not save, to use that term loosely, but how much of the ESSER money would be utilized that we're cutting. That would be that much, $923,911.
So the reductions are coming up accordingly to what this amount is?
Yes.
Okay.
Because remember, not everything out of ESSER was for positions. Remember, there was ESSER money used for a lot of other things. Those things just ended. We're only talking about those that are impacted by positions funded by ESSERs.
Okay. I only asked that question. Only one. Go ahead.
One more question. On some of these, I remember that the hours were increased, correct me if I'm wrong, during the COVID time that we had need of additional personnel.
Yes.
And we were getting funded through?
Yes, ESSER.
ESSER also?
Cover, yes. Uh-huh. So that one with the reduction, which is a separate resolution, the one that's coming up after, but I can speak to it now or you want me to wait?
No, it's actually, well.
Yeah, I'm speak to it now.
It's part of this one.
It's part of this.
It is, but it, yeah, okay. So that one is an MOU that was signed with CSEA. In March of 2023 to extend out the MOU to increase the hours for certain classified positions that are listed. up until June 30th, 2024. So that one is by the result of the sunsetting of an MOU with CSEA. So it's terminating June 30th, 2024. So it's returning back to their original hours, given that we don't have the funding to pay for the additional time. The funding had come from ESSERS, but now that there's no ESSERS, we would not have the funding to cover that.
Any other questions? I'll entertain only one question. Go ahead, man.
No.
Okay, thank you. That being said, any other questions, board members, comments?
So I just want to make sure that when we entered these positions and we funded them and we filled them, et cetera, everyone came in with their eyes wide open, pretty much, is what you're telling me, correct?
Yes.
And so this is simply not a surprise. Elimination.
No, it should not be a surprise. Now, remember, this is 3 years ago, yes? So 3 years ago was a different superintendent. I don't know exactly what was said or how it was rolled out, but the way it was rolled out in all the other districts and in my prior district, it was clearly delineated that this is temporary funding. Other districts chose not to even do any hiring of positions utilizing ESSER funds for the same reason. So you have to avoid going through this, but this is something that is something that we inherited, and we tried diligently to try to find additional funding. At this point, we do not have that additional funding unless we absorb it by the general fund, and then we run the risk of what Mr. Caff is speaking to, and then the county will decide who we lay off and who we cut.
Since you weren't here at time of this, maybe the board, a board member that was sitting at the time can tell me, what was the reasoning using ESSER funds to fill these positions?
I could, if you mind. The whole purpose of this was we were going through COVID. We're dealing with kids with a lot of issues, parents, things like that. This additional funding was brought in to assist these kids going through these critical times. The state gave the funding for these specific positions, nurses, aides, psychiatrists, counselors, stuff like that, to help these children get through this time period. So we're now through this time period. Yeah, COVID is still here, but it's not like it used to be, and everybody's working at home and back and forth. So that was the whole key behind this funding, and now it's not there anymore. So I guess the government decided that it might take 3 or 4 years, and sure enough, it did. And now that funding's gone. So we decided to hire more people to take care of these kids during that period. A lot of other districts didn't do that. So we brought in more people to make this happen, to take care of our kids. And that's why we are where we are right now.
Wait,
excuse me.
That's not even the point.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. That being said, we do have a motion on the floor by Ms. Lopen, second by Mr. Macker.
That was for discussion.
That was only for discussion. So we go back to 13.3. Do I have a motion? Second time, do I have a motion? Third time, do I have a motion? Due to lack of motion, doesn't pass. Thank you. We go to 13.4. Consideration to approve resolution 25.-3-06-24, determining skipping the competence criteria for purpose of certificate of reduction for 24-25 school year. Do we have a motion?
Move.
We have a motion on the floor. We have a motion on the floor by Mr. Macarino, second by Ms. Lopez. Is that correct?
Yes. Yes.
Did you have a comment, Ms. Lopez?
I'm not sure about the word skipping on here. I think there should be some other. determining skipping and competency criteria. It just looks like there's something missing in that wording.
The wording was screened through legal.
Yeah, but
so this is the terminology that is used.
That doesn't mean that it doesn't always make sense, but skipping, reducing, it's kind of, I don't know, it's kind of a little grammar school or something. I have no idea. It just doesn't make a lot of
sense.
Do you have a question, Mr. Alvarez?
Same question Alice asked. It doesn't make a lot of sense.
We don't like to do skipping around here.
Yeah.
According to my understanding, this was the wording from our attorneys.
Yeah.
That'd be determining.
Ms. Gomez, do you have any questions? Skipping. Mr. Macarino, do you have any more questions?
No.
And Ms. Lopez, do you have any questions?
No.
I don't at this time either. That being said, we do have a motion on the floor by Mr. Macarino, second by Ms. Lopez. Is that correct?
Yes.
We'll go with vote individually. Mr. Alvarez?
Yes.
Ms. Gomez?
No.
Mr. Macarino?
Yes.
Ms. Lopez?
Yes.
Mr. Vasquez? No. It goes 3-2. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be going to closed session at 6:33. We'll be discussing 20.1, public employee discipline, dismissal, release, excuse me, and 20.2, public employee performance evaluation, superintendent. At this time, we'll be going to closed session at 6:33.
Yeah, I
work to the left. I work to the right.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please drive home carefully. You can stick around for the rest of the meeting. We will be going to closed session. Not sure how long we're going to be in there, but you feel free to stick around if you like. go back into open session at 8:27. Action taken in closed session item. 21.1, public employee dismissal, release, complaint, government code 54957. During the closed session, the board should not discuss specific charges, complaints, or against the employee. If you believe in that, necessary discussion. Once the board returns to open session, the board will report the following action. During closed session, during closed session, on a motion by Ms. Lopez, second by Mr. Macarino, the board voted to approve the resolution to non-reelect 17-03-06-24 probationary certificated employee at the conclusion of the current school year. The superintendent has been authorized to issue the appropriate notice to non-reelection as required by law. The roll call voted was 5-0 to approve.
And then you read the, each one.
The next item on the motion by Ms. Lopez, second by Mr. Macarino, the board voted to approve the resolution to non-reelect 18-03-06-24 probationary certificated employee at the conclusion of the current school year. The superintendent has been authorized to issue the appropriate notice of the non-reelection as required by law. The roll call was as follows, 5-0 approved.
I think on 17, the motion was John Alvarez and
Ruben. No, which one?
On 17, the first one.
The first one was
17-03-06.
Was that you, Mr. Alvarez, that motion on that?
I believe so.
Go back to the 17-03-06-24 to be corrected. The motion was made by Mr. Alvarez, second by Mr. Macarena. Is that correct?
Yes.
And the motion still passed 5-0. We stand corrected with the 18-03-06-24. We go to the next one on the motion of Alvarez and Gomez. Is that correct? The board approved the resolution of non-elected 19-03-06-24. Probationary certificate employee at the conclusion of the current school year. The superintendent has been authorized to issue the appropriate notice of non-reelection as required by law. The roll call vote was as follows, 5-0, passed. On the motion of by Mrs. Gomez, second by Mrs. Lopez, the board approved the resolution to non-reelect 20.03-06-24 probationary certificated employee at the conclusion of the current school year. The superintendent has been authorized to issue the appropriate notice of non-reelection as required by law. The roll call voted with as follows, 5-0 approved. Next, motion by Mr. Macarino, second by Mrs. Lopez. The board approved the resolution to non-reelect 21-03-06-24 probationary certificate and employee at the conclusion of the current school year. The superintendent has been authorized to issue the appropriate notice of non-reelection as required by law. The roll call was as followed, 5-0 passed. Next, we move on to 21.2, public employee performance evaluation. This evaluation was only a review for 6 months. No action taken. At this time, we go to 22.0, adjournment at 8:32.
Move.
Second.
We have a motion on the floor to move by Ms. Lopez, second by Mr. Oliver. Is that correct?
Yes.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, carries 5-0. The board is adjourned. Thank you. Thank you so very much for sticking around, and please drive home carefully.